My name remains Honorable Uju Kingsley Chima, representing Ohajebema Oguta Oru West Federal Constituency of Imo State. Mr. Speaker, this motion, as proposed by our colleagues from Zamfara State, is not just peculiar to Zamfara State or Northwest, but what we are saying is that security challenge in the country is very, very alarming. Mr. Speaker, today is Zamfara. Yesterday it was Oyo State, Osun State. Few weeks ago or a few months ago, it was other Anambra kidnapping, Imo kidnapping, Rivers kidnapping, and almost all parts of the country. And I stay here to say, how long shall we continue to discuss issue of security without matching it with action? I was not in the last assembly, but I know that such discussions have come several times on this Alo chambers. Most actions taken, we don't know whether it was implemented, yet to be implemented, or about to be implemented. But my submission is that this House owes very great duty to the country and the people of Nigeria on how best we can curb the issue of insecurity in the country. And I want to propose that one of the major solutions to this issue of insecurity all over the country is having a community-based approach to solving security problems. And another approach is finding a way to actually amend the Police Act. We can't continue to talk about insecurity in the country. We can't continue to talk about solutions to insecurity in the country without, first of all, amending that Security Act that will actually enable and guarantee some level of strength and capacity to every policeman who is ready to combat this crime. Mr. Speaker, let me start an example. Like my colleague rightly said, you can't punish somebody who killed or who murdered another person. You can't punish him by asking him to go and pay 100 naira or to be sentenced for 2 weeks or three months, because we are still operating with the old Police Act, which is over 30 years old. So my submission is that this House had to give some serious biting teeth to amending the Security Act so as to give both the families of the police officers who may, in the course of their operation, lose their life, both giving them insurance, improving their welfare, and even the quality of ammunition we're using in the country. If you watch the weaponry being used by the bandits, whether they want to believe it or not, I remember a few days ago, the chief of army staff said that the morale of the military men are very low. And the question this house should ask is, what made the morale of the military officers to be very, very low? One, from my own understanding, is that the weaponries they are using are not very sufficient to combat the challenges they meet in the field. Another aspect I know that we need to equally look at is, not just on the weaponry, how do these officers interface with the communities? Because the order and the control command centers at Abuja, you see that most villages, communities, even local government do not know whom their DPO is, do not know who the military commander is. So there should be community approach, community-based approach to solving this issue of security in the country. Until this is done, I believe that we should still be discussing issue of security in Zamfara, Ogun, Imo, or any other part of the country. We should still be discussing it without having a permanent solution to it. So I so support the motion with an amendment that there should be proper declaration of national security emergency we should declare security emergency in the country so as to take the security challenges very, very serious. And the Police Act should be amended in order to meet up with the challenges of the day, of the realities of ground. We can't continue using batons and some of the weapons and equipment the police use to combat crime in such areas that the weapons they use are so sophisticated. So these are some of the realities of ground that we should employ as a House. I so support the motion. Thank you very much.